Salam ta fellow Rastafari. On the film The Return of the Judah, an individual, well, more exact, PI84ENT posted a question, and it's a really good question, and so we're gonna go ahead and present on it. And the question reads as follows: Greetings, I have a question. When the I say that Haile Selassie first is Abba, is the I referring to the man Haile Selassie or the name? Question mark. And so somewhere along the line in some of these posted comments, Matthew chapter 23 is chapter 23 verse 9 is referenced. And if ones would be kind enough, and if ones are willing and able, go ahead, open up scripture to New Testament, Mateus, Wengel, the Gospel of Matthew, and chapter 23, verse 9, and it reads as follows: And call no man your father upon the earth, for one is your father, which is in heaven. And so basically, the question is kind of like somewhere in the commenting, it was mentioned that because of this verse, that it's I mean, personally, it's overstood, it's understood how once could kind of see a contradiction in Ayin Dias Rastafari calling our God and Father, Kedamawi Haile Selassie. And so we went deeper into it, and as a matter of fact, I mean, we honestly, as soon as we read this question, we honestly did not had never even asked that question. Did not even think about it, and honestly did not know up until the very moment that we answered. We actually thought that we had no answer for it. And so let us go on to how it is that Ayin Dias addressed this question. And so it reads as follows. This is how we responded. That is truly a good question, and we are deeply grateful for it. We do not pretend that our answer is the most correct. We ourselves are as children seeking to grow in truth. We ask that we be corrected if necessary. And then we open parentheses and it reads as follows: From our understanding, Abba is more of a loving way to say father in Amharic, kind of like daddy. And so, that was a mistake on our behalf. We apologize for that. We were in fact thinking of the word Ababa, and so yeah, it definitely doesn't that doesn't really, or at least we're not too sure if it corresponds or not, but we think it doesn't, being that initially we were thinking of the word Ababa, not Abba. And so yeah, we apologize for that mistake. And then the fact that we typed in "from our understanding" is kind of testimony to the fact that we are not all that in good standing as far as the Amareña, the Amharic. And so let us close parentheses and continue. So reads as follows: the word must be received in its entirety, wholly and completely. Therefore, it is not possible to separate the word from its faithful fulfillment in the life and character of His Imperial Majesty. The name first power of the Trinity is an outline of what has been manifested in the person, Haile Selassie first, and simply cannot be separated. Both the name and the faithful fulfillment are one. And so we give thanks to we're not sure if it's a brother or sister, but we give thanks to PI84ENT. And as a matter of fact, we've been reading some of the I's comments, and we're kind of impressed. I mean, the brother or sister is obviously up to par as far as the studies. There's some knowledge that excuse that the individuals posted that we were kind of like, oh wow, we would have never thought about that. So we give thanks for the desire and the will to study, and the we give thanks for initiating this process, which was in fact all due to a really good question. And so let us go on forward. So being that we honestly did not think to have an answer up until the very second that we typed in whatever it is we typed in, we actually decided to go deeper into this because we weren't really sure. And so it turns out that from the evidence that we were able to obtain, it was a really good answer. And so that right away it manifested an idea, a thought within I. And so this the reason we're addressing this, not only because the actual evidence is very necessary and interesting, but the will to initiate a process, you know, whether it be unknowingly or knowingly, but just something as simple as asking a question, it resulted in so much, and so we give much thanks. I mean, we can't stress upon all the eyes how necessary this is, because it's not a small matter, regardless what ones would think. But we came to the conclusion that this is our weapon of choice. I would say this is how we are to you know, through language, share education via communicating. And so this allows for movement. And so it reminded us of Old Testament, how oftentimes it's been said that I and I is a stiff-necked people. And so we are not to be that way. We are to be flexible. And then, you know, that just initiated the a sequence of events or ideas within I and I mind, as far as movement and the spirit and the necessity for I and I to allow freedom of movement and flexibility to the spirit, and therefore the spirit can therefore motivate us, guide us, inspire us to do that will, that good will of our God and Father, Kedemawi Kaila Selassie, in and through Christ Jesus. And so the movement, it's like we got to keep moving. But you know, up until this very question, movement, although we had an understanding of its metaphysical reality, we had not really come to grips with actually presenting it. And so this is a great opportunity. We must not limit mobility to a flesh physical. And so in a way, and as a matter of fact, we personally accept this to be more of a more real movement, mobility, the fact that the act of transportation, transporting or journeying, traveling, moving, going to and fro of thoughts, ideas, education, knowledge, research, information, even feelings, emotions, attitudes, questions, answers, overstandings, understandings in some cases, just the movement of communication, moving along through language, moving along what is our education in communicating. And so that allows for the spirit, because being that the nature of the thoughts and ideas and opinions and all that being shared and being moved, being allowed the freedom of travel, being that its nature is of the spirit of Gita Jesus Christus, then it allows for you know, spontaneous acts of spirit manifesting into thoughts and ideas, at least in on the behalf of them receiving the ideas, or it, like in this case, I mean, we read the question and we had no idea. After doing some research, turns out we responded well. But more than that, it allowed for so much to just get rolling, to get that ball rolling, because of the movement, because of movement of ideas or whatever. And so, we seek to kind of like make it known how important it is. You know, we are not to be stuck. You know, if we get stuck and just are there, then we become defeated. We must continue and keep moving and allow for the spirit to dwell within I and I, to do that which it originally sought to do. And so all we have to do is keep moving and let us not limit our mobility to a fleshy, like physical interpretation, you know. This is we give much thanks, and this is very important for our spiritual warfare. You know, this is a movement, right? Rastafari movement, Exodus of Jah people, right? And so we got to keep moving, and whether it be information. And so it's like, if we don't, it's we're frozen psychologically, we're stuck there. It's like, I'll give an example. Whenever, let's say you're going to the kitchen and you're going to get something and you forget, right? If you just stand there, forget it. You're stuck, and you're just going to stand there and waste your time. But if you just keep moving, all right, you forgot what it is we're going to do, and just do something else or go back, and you'll remember. And if you don't remember, that means that you really shouldn't be doing that which you thought you wanted to do. And so, I mean, just we must walk in faith, right? And so, I mean, there's so many ways to put this example. Like, for instance, an acquaintance of I, you know, often, well, you know, since his 18th birth date, he's probably been free for, like, I don't know, the last 10 years. He's been out probably like a few years out of those whole 10 years, right? So he's always in prison. But we were talking about a year ago, and so he was describing to I a tattoo he wanted done on his neck and stuff like that. And so we don't know how it came to be, but it turns out that we ended up kind of like making mention how we personally really enjoyed prison art or tattoo artistry, you know. And so, or it's more correctly like individual's expression of personality, of self, right? And so we broke it down in a way that we made known how in prison, even though the physical is completely on lockdown and controlled, and all the physical surroundings is controlled, the spirit is not. And because the physical is under control, complete control, and incarcerated, it allows for the spirit to move freely. And it's unfortunate that ones have to result in having the physical, you know, incarcerated to allow for the freedom of movement to the spirit, right? But nonetheless, it's only an example. And so the physical, because they are not in complete control of what they can actually do, it kind of limits their influence in what actually gets done. And so that, in a sense, gives an opportunity to the spirit to do its thing without having physical and fleshy influence ruin whatever the spirit sought to do. And we say this because if ones are tattooing inside a prison, it's, I mean, the conditions will always be different, even though you're in the same situation. The emotions and the tension around everything will affect the art itself, and then the fact that it's illegal. And so ones are, you know, they get their makeshift tattooing gun and they start working on it. The whoever manufactured the gun will have influence in how the art actually ends up at or results, and the conclusion of the art will be influenced by the machine itself. And then the time, it takes a long time. And so, like, for instance, like, you're not all that free, you're kind of looking over your shoulder, you got some people watching out, some other inmates, and then, you know, if the case may be, they sound the alarm, the trumpets are blown, you hide all the evidence as if nothing had happened. And so there's interruptions, and but it allows for the spirit to put in the mind of the individual that's actually doing the art to change his mind, to accept, receive opinions, ideas, to kind of like change an attitude, change emotion, to make corrections, to make mistakes because of, I don't know, a fight broke out, someone pushed them, and because of that so-called unfortunate series of events, now there's an opportunity to work with that mistake and make it what it was intended to be via the spirit, right? But in a fleshy sense, we would never understand, right? We would think that the art is ruined, but the mistakes allow for such creativity, and more. It's not even creativity, it's the spirit kind of like guiding its will into the flesh and making it manifest in the representation, in the artistry, and so whatever design it turns out to be. And so all this plays effect, and then you could only tattoo for a few, sometimes minutes, sometimes seconds. You don't know what's going to happen, you know. And so like it may take months, and so throughout months, throughout years, a lot of emotions can be inputted into this ultimate grand design. And so basically it turns out to be some of the best art that I've seen. We're not supporting tattoos, and we're not supporting the you know, the prison life, but the point we're trying to make is that it's unfortunate that we have to put the physical on lockdown, but us Rastafari, we could learn from that and not commit those mistakes. We ourselves can seek to control the physical and kind of allow for the spirit to do such things, you know, and as post questions, and that will cause a chain of events. You know, it's a fruit bearing seed within itself, and you know, bringing forth more fruit and abundant rivers of water, you know, and stuff like that. So basically we're trying to express the necessity of Ras Tefri to move and to get moving. It don't matter, no work, you know, be it for the ultimate purpose of our good creator, is too small for Ras Tefri, and no shame in the game. That's why we're proud workmen. You don't need not to be ashamed, rightfully dividing the word of truth. And so we just wanted to do that little comment on that. And it's cause you know, when we start allowing like man's influence, and what if that question is too foolish, or what if they're gonna think this or that, then everything goes to, I mean, then you're frozen psychologically, and William Lynch inevitably becomes the victor. And so it's because this has been on our minds like all the time. And this is the wise mind of His Imperial Majesty Kedamawi Kaila Selassie. And so it reads, it is sound tactic of military strategy to attack, excuse that, to attack where your opponent's defense is weakest. It is surely sound strategy. So sound tactic of military strategy is like, a tactic is only like a side plan, one of many different ideas within a bigger picture to make the goal made manifest. And so, but it is so sound tactic of military strategy to attack where your opponent's defense is weakest, right? But it is surely sound strategy. I mean, it is sound strategy. It's not a tactic. Sound strategy is kind of mentioning, including the whole picture, the big picture, not just little tricks or you know, I guess little missions within the big picture. And so it reads as follows: for all of us to move ahead where such movement is unobstructed and unimpeded. And so we got to move ahead where such obstructions are possible. And so, you know, we're not even going to go into that, but yeah, we always have that in our minds, and we know that that sometimes we don't know what to study, honestly, and so you know, these are great opportunities. Questions like these are great opportunities, because maybe if we weren't thinking of what to study, it's because that's whatever we would have thought is not exactly what the spirit would have desired. And so it makes it a whole lot easier for the spirit to be allowed flexibility within movement, because then it could use other individuals to ignite or you know, light the fuse to whatever inner enlightenment would be enlightened in this other individual. So I mean, just putting that out there, it's true. it's truth. And so let us continue. We kind of got into that. So you know what? Let us pause right here and let us just focus on answering the question on a following presentation. We give thanks to all and die.